In sports, PBA player Paul Desiderio vehemently denies allegations of domestic abuse made against him by his former partner. In a social media post, the Blackwater player says he never abused his accuser, Agatha Yuvero, during their relationship. Desiderio adds he has never hurt a woman, especially the mother of his child. Yuvero accused the former UP Maroon star of beating her up when she was still pregnant. The PBA has launched a probe on Yuvero's claim, and Desiderio says he is willing to face that investigation. Music streaming platform Spotify introduces the video podcast feature in the Philippines. Users now have the option to switch between audio only and video. In a statement, Spotify vows to continue pushing the podcasting industry in the Philippines. For more on this story, head on over to news.abs-cbn.com. An online business in Canada aims to teach Filipino culture to kids and young adults in a fun way. Rowena Papasin tells us how.
It was during the pandemic when parents would look around for activities that they could do with their kids that preschool teacher and young mom Christine Lim realized there were no Pinoy children's books in Canada. Lim decided to bring these books from the Philippines and offer them on the Summit Kids website.
And through some markets, like the one that was organized by the Philippine Consulate, we were able to let the families here know that we have books and products proudly made in the Philippines available for the families.
Lim, who also runs the Summit Kids After School program in Richmond, BC, wanted to make learning the Filipino language and culture more fun for the kids. So she also got games like the Pinoy Snakes and Ladder, where the adventure takes players to the different provinces of the Philippines, flashcards that describe a child's different emotions in Tagalog, and a play kit of Songka, Sipa, and Chinese garter. Lim said many Filipino parents are glad to learn new things as well.
Some of them are second generation Filipinos, would say, oh, sana when we were growing up, we had these here. And so having the books that allowed them to teach Filipino and English and part of the culture to the families, they were very happy.
Lim added, teaching Tagalog to young Filipino-Canadians can also break the language barrier between them and their grandparents.
It's always hard for the lolas and the lolos to be with the younger kids because of the language barrier and even the cultural barrier. So I wanted to bring books in the classroom so that kids would understand the grandparents.
Young Filipino-Canadians have also started collecting many of the books from the Summit Kids website as a way for them to connect with their homeland.
We also know a lot of Filipinos who are in their 30s who can't speak Tagalog, can't read Tagalog, but they want to be more connected to the culture.
Right.
So these books are great starter points for adults who want to connect back to their Filipino roots.
It's important to look back and connect with our roots pa rin. And a great way to do that is with literature, kahit pambata.
Lim is glad that through her online bookshop, she is able to impart to the second and third generation Filipinos here that the Filipino culture is more than just food and family gatherings. To date, Summit Kids has gotten orders from the East Coast, the U.S., and even from Australia. Rowena Papasin, ABS-CBN News, Richmond, British Columbia.